Hey guys, this is Ash, and you're watching WriterGAsh. Welcome to day 7 of 2 weeks of ACOTAR. So today I'll be doing a non-spoilery book talk for ACOMAF, and I'm gonna warn you, if you have not read ACOTAR, you probably shouldn't be watching this video, but I really suggest you read ACOTAR because ACOMAF is an amazing book. If I had to choose, which was my favorite book of all time, I would go with ACOMAF. As of right now, maybe I love ACOWAR even more, and I'm so excited. I just actually received my ebook copy of ACOWAR, and I'm in love. I'm literally smitten with everything. I just finished reading chapter 13. If you guys have read ACOWAR, you guys know what I'm talking about. And it was so amazing. I was literally jumping up and down. But in order to get to that, you have to read ACOMAF. And in order to read ACOMAF, you have to read ACOWAR, which is amazing, by the way. A Court of Mist and Fury is basically a retelling of Hades and Persephone's story, and it's so fantastic. I am warning you, if you have not read ACOTAR or you don't know what happened in ACOTAR, you probably shouldn't watch this video because I'm about to mention things that happened at the end of ACOTAR, and that wouldn't really be favorable if you, that would really spoil you. And it's an amazing book, even if you do get spoiled, it's still enjoyable. But I don't want to spoil you guys, so I really suggest you go read it and then come back. Anyways, so in ACOTAR, Farah, our main protagonist, makes a bargain with Rhysand, who is such an amazing character, wherein she has to spend 1 week every month at his court, which is the Night Court. And Rhysand is basically portrayed as this dark overlord who is feared by all, who has committed so many heinous crimes, and we just jump right into how Farah is dealing with everything that happened in ACOTAR and how she's coping with what happened under the mountain. And we see her struggling and things happen that really piss me off, but it's so amazing. It's like the good kind of pissing off. And the story is like the best it can be. And it's just such an amazing book. And everything that happens in it is phenomenal. The characters are amazing. Court, the Night Court is marvelous. We meet the members of the Night Court and they literally challenge what you believe, and it's like everything you've learned up to now has been given a different point of view. You learn things from a different perspective and you go back to what you've heard before and you're like, did I really think that? That's happened to me like a lot. This book was fantastic, and the quotes in this book were given in such a detail. It was amazing, and especially the ending. I had to wait one year to find out what happened to the characters, and I was in love with it, and it was killing me. And if you guys have not read it, you guys should, because you don't have to wait 1 year for it. But the wait, like, I've read this book so many times because of the intense feelings I undergo because of the book, that I've just got lines memorized. I've got so many parts of the book memorized. I have got like 50 pages of notes for this, and I don't know how I'm gonna do the spoilery book talk without, well, speaking for hours. I'm probably gonna speak for hours in the spoilery book talk. Anyways, I know I'm ranting right now, but I'm gonna stop. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and give it a thumbs up if you did. Come back tomorrow to watch the full book talk, because I have so much to discuss when it comes to this book. This is my favorite book of all time, and I guess I'm in love with Rhysand, and he's hands down the best being.